Well, joining us now, Gavin Medgley, a senior teaching fellow in accounting who studies our retail sector with interest. Gavin, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
We've been focusing on one high street in our region. It's very easy to blame the effect of online shopping, but is that the only reason why businesses are suffering?
Not at all. I think the changes that have happened in behaviour and why people aren't visiting their high streets as much comes down to a perceived lack of value. Now, that's lack of value in terms of the cost. Maybe they see that there's cheaper alternatives, but also lack of value in the experience that they get from there, and the convenience and the quality as well. All of these things, people make the choice to think, you know, what do I want to do here? And very often it's the high street retailers that lose out.
Well, as well as the stores we've already mentioned, Bill's department stores are in trouble. If big name retailers can't compete, how do smaller independent stores stand a chance?
Well, smaller businesses can do it by making clear the value that's being added by them in terms of what are they bringing to the local economy. The more we spend in the local businesses, the more our money stays within that and helps growth. Just having the retailers there is often, you know, a positive thing. It can even affect property prices as well. So there's a lot of things that the small businesses can do, but it requires innovation and bringing something that's a bit new.
Now, one sector that's defined the downhill slump in recent years is the vape shop. Now, the southeast is the fastest growing for vaping shops. Think about 9% rise last year. I mean, can you explain this?
Yes, as it's a relatively new product and a relatively new popular product, it's something that hasn't really established a sort of an online presence. They see it as something that can only be got in the sort of the bricks and mortar. And I suppose that's the thing, is where you've got an industry that is popular but has established itself in bricks and mortar, that's where you'll see the increase in shops. Take tattoo places, for example. We've all seen plenty of those.
The big question, how do we save our high streets?
I think there needs to be three things. Firstly, change in behaviour from the state in terms of making shopping more popular, either by changing business rates, offering more attractive business rates, parking, but also maybe online sales taxes. Secondly, changes in the shops themselves, offering that uniqueness, offering that value, and also changes in what we do, you know, seeing where the value is added. And if we value these places, maybe we should shop there more.
Gavin Medgley,